Half of Canada's 39 million people live below this red line, with the majority living in close proximity to three of the five Great Lakes. Yet, few of these people know that within one of these Great Lakes is the site of a vast impact crater. Located in Lake Ontario, the impact structure can be found at an almost equidistant location between Main Duck Island, Grenadier Island, and Simcoe Island. Even on Google Earth, the outline of this feature is fairly visible. It measures 1.3 kilometers or 4,265 feet wide and 19 meters or 62.3 feet deep. If only humans had evolved 3 million years earlier than they did, this feature may have been a significant tourist attraction or the site of some interesting architectural design which utilized the crater's curvature. As Lake Ontario did not exist until 15,000 years ago, and between 15,000 and 2.6 million years ago, the region was intermittently covered by kilometer-thick glaciers. These carved away at much of the crater's existing rim and filled in what was at one point a 276-meter or 905-foot deep depression in the ground that cut all the way below sea level. So, simply imagine what a conifer forest-filled landscape with an impact crater looked like that was almost identical in size to the much more recent Meteor crater in Arizona. Since the crater called the Charity Shoal is less than 2 kilometers or 1.2 miles wide in diameter, it does not contain any central rings or a central peak, as instead it is merely a bowl-shaped depression marking what is known as the simple impact crater. However, we strangely are unsure of how old this impact structure is. While current estimates seem to suggest an age of 460 million years old, this is not a definitive age. As, while the edges of this impact structure contain 470 million year old rock, this merely represents a maximum age for its formation, as it must have already existed at the time of the collision. And yet, the crater's fairly small size is highly unusual, as, generally speaking, simple impact craters are almost completely erased from the surface within 100 million years. This fact suggests that the Charity Shoal could have formed perhaps as little as 3 million years ago. Yet, exceptions do in fact exist, as, for example, the Kerkoselka crater in Finland is a simple 1.4 kilometer wide impact crater which is still visible on the surface and is about 240 million years old. However, due to the placement of Charity Shoal, circumstantial evidence places it in a cluster of large middle Ordovician impact events which stretch all the way from Oklahoma to Estonia. While these areas do not form a perfect straight line today, 465 million years ago they would have due to the different placement of various tectonic plates. These large craters outlined in red all presumably formed between 467.5 and 464.5 million years ago during a cataclysm known as the Ordovician meteor event, where the inner solar system experienced the highest rate of asteroid impacts during the last 1 billion years. During this period, asteroids of all sizes suddenly began to pelt Earth at a rate 100 times higher than is normal. This means that events similar in magnitude to that which formed the Charity Shoal occurred every 60 years for a time, instead of a normal every 6,000 years. This all occurred due to the destruction of an approximately 100-mile or 161-kilometer-long asteroid in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, which was caused when an object half its diameter collided with it 468 million years ago. Many of the collision's resulting fragments were then sent into the inner solar system, beginning an era of greatly increased asteroid impacts. In the case of the asteroid which formed the Charity Shoal structure, it measured a mere 84 meters or 275.6 feet wide. Entering Earth's atmosphere, this 1.12 million metric ton massive rock was racing towards the surface at a speed of 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. Impacting the surface, an immense amount of energy equivalent to the detonation of 4.94 megatons of TNT occurred, releasing a shockwave which initially generated 3,500 mile per hour winds. All plant and animal life was killed in an instant within a 7 kilometer radius. Trees were all toppled facing outwards from the blast to a distance of 20 kilometers, while tree damage occurred to a distance of 32 kilometers. I want to note that the Great Lakes also contain another impact crater known as the Slate Islands in Lake Superior. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.